My name is Senator Mike Gabbard, and as a member of the Red Hill Fuel Storage Facility Task Force and the current chair of the Senate Water, Land, and Agriculture Committee, I'd like to offer the following comments on the recently signed AOC. Also, what I mentioned before I get into my remarks is that the Senate and the House, we passed a concurrent resolution that extends the task force, and it also, now the task force includes the congressional delegation, which is a good thing, because after all, that's what we're really talking about here, right? And secondly, which is something I found out in one of the task force meetings, is that in addition to these 20 tanks, there is another 26 tanks. That when I asked at one of the meetings, I said, what's the status of these tanks that are also over 70 years old? No one really had an answer. So we are also looking at those additional 26 tanks.
Where?
So given that there were delays in reaching an agreement, it was a positive step that the EPA, the DOH, Navy, and DLA tentatively agreed to the AOC. This document does require that the Navy and the DLA to make improvements to the tanks, which must be approved by the EPA and DOH to better protect our water supply. I know that during the 22-year timeline for the AOC, the Navy has agreed to shut down any tank that doesn't meet, quote, best available practical technology, unquote. This agreement also allows the Navy and DLA to initiate pilot programs which incorporate the latest advanced technologies. So these are important actions. However, one thing that I and many people in the public are feeling is that there is a lack of urgency in moving forward with these needed improvements.
Yeah.
And based on the fact that these 20 tanks, which can each hold 12.5 million gallons of fuel, are just 100 feet above 25% of the island's drinking water, is an enormous concern for our future. With this in mind, I'm suggesting that in addition to the initial two-year study put forth in the AOC, the Navy and the DLA move as quickly as possible to upgrading the fuel release prevention and detection facility. This is urgently needed to calm public fears and to show good faith that the Navy and the DLA are serious about being good stewards of our precious environment. Without an additional commitment, it is unlikely that the AOC will gain widespread community support. Mahalo for considering my comments.